Tauren talk about the anticipation of practice starting tomorrow, what the feeling is among the guys as you get ready to get to work out there?
I'm excited, and I hope the rest of the team is. all the hard work we've put in, it's been tough this offseason. I'm just excited to see the strides we're going to make in during practice.
Tauren, what difference do you think it will make having the same coach, the entire same coaching staff there this year for fall camp as last year?
Well, I think it'll make a huge difference. Now that Coach Dooley's in his second year, we definitely know what he wants. We're definitely comfortable with him, and he's built our trust, and it's just exciting to know that we have somebody like that in this program, and the expectations he have for us as a team, as individuals, and as young men. So it's definitely going to carry over on the field, and that's especially what I'm excited about this whole offseason. We've tried to instill his principles within our whole work ethic and everything that we do, and Coach Ron McKeefer has done a great job in doing that, and the leaders of this team has tried to do it as much as possible. So it's definitely getting through to us.
Have you noticed that Tyler gained weight, or does he still look just as skinny to you?
I heard he said he was 202 now. I'm like, still little, but he's gained a little bit. I think he's gained like 10 pounds maybe, but Tyler should be like 220. Let's be real, but I doubt that ever happened. But as long as he can throw the ball around, we'll find whatever way he's at.
What do you think can be gained from these first few practices being split up between veterans and freshmen? How do you think that's essential, I guess, going forward into the season to kind of break him in like that?
Well, I mean, maybe to split the freshmen up is kind of just like build them up, kind of get them a feel for what's going on, because I'm pretty sure it's kind of tough going right from freshmen straight into with the vets. But it's pretty good, and the vets is just so we can play fast, so the game doesn't slow down with freshmen in there. And I think that's the whole point of it. I know there's going to be a couple of freshmen that works with the older guys, but for the guys that aren't ready yet, I think that's why they split them up.
Do you have goals for the season as far as a team, points you'd want to average per game or minimum points in a given game? Have you set goals like that?
I set goals, but I don't set those kind of goals. My goal is just kind of like be a leader and to leave something behind at UT and just win ball games. And I don't set point goals or such things like that. But my goal is just to make UT a better football team and win ball games. And I've written them down. They're printed out and ready to go.
Are you convinced that Tennessee will run the football better this year than a year ago?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I think we will. And I have to show that in camp. Me and Rajon and Marlon and all the other running backs, we have to show that we can run the football. And then we have to run the football to win ball games. Tyler has a great arm, but we can't just depend on a little bitty arm to lead us, even though he's a great quarterback. But I definitely have a point to prove to Coach Dooley that we can run the football and that we should run the football.
What do you think are the key factors in developing that running game where you want it to be?
It starts when we get in pads, which is probably tomorrow or Wednesday. It starts in practice now, and we kind of got to develop as a team. And because Coach Dooley, he has to see it in order for us to actually run the football. He wants to see it. He wants us to show it. So it definitely puts it in our hands as players to show Coach that we should and need to run the football.
That added strength and maturity to the offensive line, how much do you think that'll
help? Oh, it helps greatly. If y'all were to see the strides that they made, it was incredible. And now it's to the point where you see the maturity, you see the growth, and now you want to see it on the field. So that's what I'm excited about, is just seeing their maturity and seeing how far they've come along. And now they have to apply it to the field, because I'm sure all the fans want to see it. I would love to see it as a running back, and I know Tyler would love to see it in protection. So it's great, and we're definitely going to be a better offense.
Tauren, all this stuff off the field concerning the NCAA and such, that's something you guys talk about, and is it – a concern at all as far as being a distraction as you guys move forward?
We don't really talk about it. Me personally, I stay away from NCAA. I let them do what they have to do, because I have no say. But Coach Dooley doesn't mention it, really. I'm guessing he tries to do everything right. He seems like the type of person that does everything right. So I don't get too much into it. I let NCAA do their deal, and I just play football.
You guys have one of the smallest senior classes in the entire conference. Yeah. Has that made you guys, maybe your small group, even tighter than maybe it was when they came in and everything like that?
I think so. We actually have like 8 guys, and it's crazy. But we're definitely closer. The seniors are very close, and we kind of rallied this team around us as seniors, as leaders. And I don't know, numbers may not have anything to do with it, but I just think it's the type of guys that we have as seniors. It's not the actual number, not the total numbers, but the guys that we have are incredible leaders and very unselfish, and they just want to win. And well, it starts now the camp is starting, and I'm excited to see the leadership that we have and go forward.
Has it been tough to kind of see them kind of go away one by one, I guess, throughout your career, I guess, here? And just kind of, did it all, like, come together as just having 8, or is just kind of a slow process to kind of get down to that small moment, I guess?
I think it was a slow process. Guys left, didn't do well academically, you know, whatever the case was. And so it was kind of like by default that we have 8 seniors, and it's such a small class, but we're excited about it. That we don't really care too much about numbers. We're definitely just ready just to lead this team as best as possible.
Tauren, when you talk about being a leader, is that something that you have to think about every day and in a lot of different ways when you say you're a leader?
I think so. And it's just for me, it's like I know a lot of people are watching me, whether it's coaches, players, and I just want to be a great example to the young guys or to whoever needs me. And I know in order to be a great football team, you got to have great leaders. And we have a couple on this football team. And we have to continue just to build more because, like you said, they come and go. Leaders come and go. And we got to continue just to create more and more leaders and make UT a better football team.
Tauren, you seem to have been doubted your whole career. You spent so much time, you know, trying just to get in the lineup. You get in the lineup, you have a 1,000-yard season, and now you're sort of ignored in the preseason. Sure. So does that fuel you? How does it fuel you? And B, what do you think you have to do to get people to finally pay attention?
Well, yeah, it does fuel me. It makes me smile because, I mean, I'm so used to it. It's been like that my whole entire life. And even if I was the number one guy, I still would realize that I have a lot to prove. I don't care where I'm at, whether I'm the lowest guy or the highest guy. I still got a lot to prove, and I still got a lot to show. And that's my point exactly. You're never where you're supposed to be. You always got to be better. And that proves my point right there. I don't know what I would have to do for anybody to count me in, maybe rush for 2,000 yards, 2,000, 3,000 yards to get. But it really doesn't matter. This team believes in me. The staff believes in me, and I definitely believe in myself. And it is what it is, and I take it for what it is, and it is motivation for me. And I'm just excited about this football team because it's not about me. They can say what they want about me, but as long as we win, it's perfectly fine.
Have you had any conversations with Arian Foster about that sort of stuff and being here?
Yeah, I have. He just told me not to pay any attention to it because he's kind of in the same boat as I am. And he's just like, let it go. God, not everybody's going to believe in you. The game is surrounded by critics, and you just got to prove them wrong and not let it affect your game. So I'm taking that exact approach. That's the approach I was going to take anyhow. And just definitely excited about what I'm going to do this season for this football team. And I'm just going to go from there. I'm just going to start on the football field because opinions don't affect my work ethic. I'm going to work hard.
Last year, you were kind of the only reliable rusher for Tennessee. How much do you think it would help you if you had a number 2 guy that could consistently get you guys 8 to 12 carries? And have you seen anything in summer that would make you believe to think there is a reliable number 2 guy to help you out?
Well, I think it will help. I think it will help a lot. And it definitely just because the wear and tear, the breakdown of your body during the 12-game stretch in the season. And I definitely seen a couple of guys that could do that. With Rajon, the guy's pound for pound one of the strongest dudes on the team. He definitely has the speed. Marlon Lane came in. He's a mature running back. So I know those guys are gonna do a great job. But my job is not secure because they're great running backs. And I'm excited about the competition that we're gonna have this offseason because it's gonna make the team better. It's gonna make us better as backs. And definitely just ready to compete with those young guys.
You mentioned that you're excited about the drill starting, but is part of you kind of dreaded in a way too because it's hot out there, you're putting on pads and that kind of thing?
Well, I'm trying not to take that approach because this is my last camp at UT, so I'm kind of trying to soak it all in and just appreciate the opportunity that I have just to have another camp at UT and able to do better things than I did last year, able to make strides. But yeah, it's gonna be hot, but there's nothing we can do about it. We still have to practice and get better. So
how did that compare to your first practice when you went into your first round of preseason practices at UT? Was it very difficult for you?
My freshman? Yeah, it was tough. I was kind of at the bottom of the barrel, kind of not really getting noticed. But I got a couple chances. I didn't really do much. I wasn't really tired then because I didn't do anything. But now I definitely have to take a different approach because I'm in that starting role and I gotta show coach that. I have what it takes, because he wants to see the mental toughness, and he says it all the time that the heat shouldn't matter. That you got to be mentally tough and be ready to go.
Even though the offensive line is young, do you think this is the most talented offensive line Tennessee has in the
program? Wow, I can't answer that because I didn't run behind those other guys. I've seen some great guys come through here. I think they have the potential to be. And we're definitely young, but we can't use as an excuse. But they're going to be great. They're already good and just have to continue just to work hard. Nobody's ever what it should be. So they realize that and then they continue to work.
Just the development of those young guys to have, it's rare to have that many freshmen, true freshmen offensive linemen anywhere, much less the SEC. Just talk about their development last fall and what do you see from them this summer?
Well, I definitely see a lot of maturity, and it came a long way. They've came a long way, and one in particular that stood out to me was Stone. This summer, he's been talking to me about defenses, stunts, and I didn't get any of that last year, so I'm like, whoa, where'd this come from? And it's great to see, and the confidence that they have in each other, and. Because they keep saying 2,000 yards, and that's bold to say that in this league. And I just tell them just to work hard. Don't worry about the 2,000 yards. Let's just work and let's just win. And they say, yeah, we're going to win, but we're going to get that 2,000. And they just continue to say it. But it takes a lot for those guys to say that, because last year you probably wouldn't hear that come out their mouth at all. But it's great to see. And this team needs the offensive line. We need every single last one of them. And I wouldn't be who I am. I wouldn't have the yards that I have without them.
What advice would you give the freshman running backs? This is what you need to do to be a Tennessee tailback.
Wow, just be relentless. Just go out every day and play every down like it's your last. And that's the message I'm gonna try to send as my last camp is just give it your all. And when your all is expected, and Coach Dooley expects your all every down, every play, and don't let up.